Excuse me, sir, would you recommend a stay at this Airbnb? No comment. Sir, I need a comment. Sir, excuse me. Sir, come back. Sir, would you stay in this silo home? Sir. Sir, I give up. Let's go and check this place out. Man, it was really tough trying to get them to cooperate for that intro. Like, I had a certain vision going into this video for the intro. Not quite sure how it came out. I guess we'll see when the edit's done, but... Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Silo House at Laughing Llama Farm. This place is actually the most wishlisted farm stay on Airbnb. It's also been featured in HGTV and Business Insider for good reason. Of course, the highlight is the fact that you're on a working farm with all of your llama friends, and the interior just has a really quirky design to it. Lots of bright colors and unique features that we've never seen before on the channel, not to mention some cool exterior amenities like an outdoor shower, and just the sole fact that you're staying in a silo is pretty cool if you ask me. So without further ado, let's not go and hop straight into the full tour. Welcome to this silo home. You'll first pull up in your car to this large private driveway, and you can see there is a big sign here so you can't miss it. But let's now go and check out the front side of the home, which you can see here. There is a section of the fence that is enclosed so that the animals can't get in. And if we zoom out, you can see more of the property. Again, this is still an active and working farm. But one of my favorite parts is the logo there on top of the silo, which says the Silo House Laughing Llama Farm. And of course, it has two llamas on it. Definitely a very unique structure, and I realized after checking, this is only the second silo home that we've ever toured before on the channel. But out here on the patio, you do have a nice little barbecue grill, and there are three chairs at the far end. So you can just sit down on them and relax and look out towards the farm because your furry friends do come up right to the fence. Next, I'll walk towards this structure with the tall metal walls, and this is your outdoor shower. I love how the owner added in some flowers here to spruce it up with some color, and you can put your towels there on the left. Outside of the shower, we can grab some wood and fire up the chimenea. But for one of the most important parts, we are going to grab some of the llama feed inside and go and feed the llamas. All right, here goes. Gonna call the llamas.
Llama, llama, ding dong.
Nope, nothing. No interest, no interest. Gotta get closer. Okay, these guys are all the way on the other side of the pasture. Oh, that one guy wants it. I see you. Come on, come on. Let's go to the silo home. Come on. My arm is getting tired from vlogging. Would you like some food, sirs? We gotta go all the way back here. Come on, dude. Let's go, let's go. Anybody else? Goat? No? No one else. One guy. Okay.
Llama, llama, ding dong.
Oh, man. This guy is tracking me. Come on. Let's go. Let's go. Oh, shit. He is going. Come on. Come on. Let's go. Come on. It's right here. So we got one llama, a goat. I think that's a baby llama. Okay, dude. We're going. Chill. You are hungry, sir. Come on. Don't stop. I'm looking at you. This guy is like attacking me. We're going. Hey, right here, buddy. Come on. There you go. Okay, I know, dude. You too. Jesus. You, sir, are the feisty one.
Now that we've fed all of our animal friends, I'll quickly show off more of the property. You do have this fishing hole. It was running a little low on water. I don't think it's rained much lately, but I'm sure it's nice to enjoy during other times of the year. And this is more of the surrounding area. But now that we've covered quite a bit on the exterior and the farm, it's time to go inside. So I'll open up this door and we're going to begin the second half of this tour. Welcome inside of the silo home. We are going to begin on the first floor, which contains your living room, kitchen, and bathroom. We have about 672 square feet of interior space in total. It's a lot more than I initially expected. I'll start to go into more detail first in the living room. You have this large plush leather couch and an additional chair, and you're probably starting to notice all of the really bright and wacky colors. It's what really sets this place apart from the others, like the bright green cabinet there in the background and your yellow door. The main wall has a big smart TV. Of course, you can't miss the painting of the llama with the glasses, and you also have this nice fireplace heater, which you could turn on with the touch of a button. Next to the front entrance, you have this bright red dining table with a few items, like a laughing llama koozie, a handwritten note from the host, and there are detailed bios on each and every farm animal. You definitely have to give all of them a read when you check in. To the right of the dining table, you can find one of those fancy screens with even more info on local restaurants and more recommendations from the host. And of course, you can't miss this bright pink zebra hat, and there are two fishing rods for the fishing hole. We've covered about half of the first floor, so we'll go into the kitchen, which has a rainbow kitchen table with a few snacks and a basket. Over here, I just assumed this was the fridge when I first walked in, but it's actually a storage area with some themed goodies like Llaminos, I cannot get over the name of that game, and a few other fun goodies. Like this is a game called Taco Cat Goat Cheese Pizza, the ever important llama feed that we saw earlier, and my personal favorite, this sign that says No Prob Llama. I love it. For the actual kitchen itself, we'll check it out briefly, but it has everything that you could possibly need for during your stay. To the left of your large sink, you have your coffee area. You also have all of your glasses and mugs and plates out and easily accessible. And then this is your actual fridge and freezer unit. If you open it up, you can find inside a bottle of wine that the host left behind, even some free water and coffee creamer, and some eggs. Towards the back of the first floor, you can find a washer and dryer unit behind this door, which I think is pretty nice to have for a home this size. This door on the right then opens up into the one bathroom in this silo home. The farm and llama themes continue, of course. My personal favorite was the Get Naked piece of art there on the left with the llama in the tub. And you can then find a multitude of towels on this shelf and even some free bathroom amenities that you wouldn't normally see in an Airbnb. Around the corner, there is then your shower with some simple white subway tile. And if you look down below, you can find some more artsy black and white floor tiling on the ground. Let's head up top to the second floor, but before we do, just look at that ceiling. I love the detail here with the individual little wood shingles and that massive ceiling fan. To get there, we're going to go up this really fancy and grand looking staircase. You have these three lighting fixtures along the wall and those three pieces of art, which I believe the host Bonnie did all by herself. Here on the second floor, you can find your bedroom. By far, my favorite piece is the bed headboard. I mean, just look at this thing. I believe it is from the trunk of a car, and they then painted it bright blue and added in the ox. I mean, just very creative and extremely eye-catching. To the right then, you have this big blue cabinet with some more storage space and some hangers and an iron. And in that far corner, you have a very comfortable chair. Finally, for this floor, if we look to the left of the bed, you have this map of the US where all past guests have pinned where they come from. I saw guests come all the way from as far as Europe and South America, and they left some notes. On the other side of the property, there is a store that the host manages. This is the host, Bonnie. She was just so sweet and fun to talk to, and she's a very impressive lady. She runs multiple businesses, and I really enjoyed speaking with her. Definitely try and have a chat if she's there. And you can purchase some fun little gifts, like some laughing llama cups, some pieces of art and murals. You'll notice some of these items that we saw inside of the silo home. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you very soon for another Airbnb tour.